shortly. All right. Oh, we do have announcements this morning, right, Andrea? Okay. Let's watch those announcements.
This is GP120, your church news in about 2 minutes.
Good morning and welcome to The Gathering Place. If it's your first time here, we are so glad that you are. I know that you're going to have a great time and hope to see you again real soon.
Hey, married folks. Next Saturday is our Marriage Matters meeting.
We'll share a carry-in meal together, followed by a short message with topics that is going to do nothing, absolutely nothing, but help the marriages in this body thrive.
Yes. And this month, our theme is chili cook-off. He'll make his super spicy chili, so. But bring your favorite chili or soup, or bring something to go along with it.
Child care will be provided.
And this group is for all married couples. You've got a great marriage, you've got a rocky marriage. Please come, make it a date night and have fun. It is, it's always fun.
Don't forget, pre-worship connection takes place every week.
There's coffee, juice, and donuts in the lobby at 10 a.m. every Sunday.
Mm-hmm. Arrive early for food and fellowship, and it's a great way to get to know your GP family.
Did you hear Pastor John's message about staying in touch with family?
Yes, it was great. And if you haven't yet signed up for the GP text group, do it today.
You'll receive event reminders and special announcements sent right to your phone.
And an occasional message from Pastor John.
So get your phone out right now and text GP to 59769 and stay connected with your GP family.
Hey church, we want to remind you that we have Sunday morning Bible study and it's awesome.
Awesome.
Yes.
Class starts at 9:30 back in the library and it's directed by Matt and Nikki Hagler.
So get here early and get into the Word.
Word.
Yeah.
Quick reminders, Armor of God Women's Study is tomorrow at 7.
Bible study Wednesday at 7.
Marriage Matters Saturday at 6.
That's it for GP 120.
Have a great week!
Good morning. How is everybody? Blessed. I'm very fortunate. On Sunday mornings, I get to pray with Steve, Tony, and Debbie. And I prayed last today. I didn't have anything to say. All of it was said before me. I love that. So I was going to have everybody just pray and me just shut up, but I don't know if you'd all do that. So how is everybody? Honestly, you woke up breathing, right? Man, what a blessing. And if you wake up dead, hey, even more. Think about it. I'm just so, the older I get, the more I realize that I want to become like a samurai. You know what the deal was with samurais, right? They weren't afraid of death because it was a bridge to something better. This life don't mean squat. It don't. It's who I affect during this life. It's who I help during this life. It's the money that God gives me to give to other people that matter. I don't need anything. I got 3 pair of blue jeans. Come on. What's wrong with you? What do you really need? My wife and I went on vacation. I was going to say I went to Gatlinburg with a beautiful woman, but I thought you might think something was wrong until I said it was my wife. My wife's beautiful. So we split meals all week. I don't need extra food. I got enough midsection to last 2 or 3 weeks. Seriously, as long as you give me water and I can drink out of a mud puddle. It's good enough for a frog. I can drink out of it. Let's pray. I want you to be thankful today. I want you to be free. God wants you to be free. If you come in for a bunch of junk, for goodness sakes, take it back outside. Take it out here and put it in the gutter where it belongs. Or bring it to the altar. We've got a Heavenly Father that is with us all the time. You can't leave Him. He never leaves you. If you say Jesus isn't present, you're lying. He's right there beside you. He walks in front of me most of the time, because I about walked into the cross a few minutes ago. That'd been funny, but big, this head takes a heck of a smack. I would have had a big old print up here, but I didn't walk into it. That's a good thing. Let's pray. Father, thank you for this day. And Lord, I mean thank you for this day. Let us approach every day like it's another day we can do your work. It's another day, Lord, let your light shine. And Lord, forgive us because our light is growing weak. The church, man, we ought to be able to drive down a highway and people say, "What passed me?" We ought to walk into some place and people say, "Well, whoa, okay, what's going on here?" Forgive us, Father, for covering up your light. They should know who we are, not by what we say or what we look like, just because of your presence. It should reek from us. We should stink like the Holy Spirit. And I don't know whether you stink or not. I'm sorry, Holy Ghost, but people should know you're there. So, Father, help us with that. Lord, today in praise and worship, let us be free. Focus on you. I'd ask for everybody here to get a dose of the kingdom so they understand what really is going on. And Father, thank you. If someone's come in here today with something heavy on their hearts, let them bring it to this altar and get rid of it. Let the saints come among them and pray it off of them, Father. Satan, we rebuke you. You have no place. There's a day going to come when you're going to burn in a fiery pit, and I hope I have a front row seat to watch it be done. Father, thank you for this day, and we give it to you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Praise the Lord. Here we come, saints. Are we ready to praise the Lord this morning?
Hey, just one second. I want all the kids to come up here with me. They're going to sing a couple more songs, but I want you guys up here with me so we can worship together. Come on up here. Yeah, that's great. We're going to worship together. And I'm going to worship with you. Thank you. than you guys are up here with me. I want you to do this every Sunday so we can clap. Aiden came up and he says, now what? We figured it out, didn't we, Aiden? Come here, I'm going to pray for all of you. I love you so much, and I'm so glad you're here. You guys are great. Lord, I pray for every one of these boys and girls in the name of Jesus, that your love is real in their hearts and minds, and they start to understand how much you really care, that you are a good, good Father, that you love them, and that they can do all things through you, Jesus, as you give them the strength and the wisdom and the power to be leaders, to excel in all that they do. They're like clay in our hands to be molded into whatever. And Lord, I want to mold it into valuable, priceless children of God. So I bless them and I thank you for them, and let the teachers just fill them full of Jesus. Amen. I love you guys.
The song, and the writer of the song lost a child, and through all of that she was trying to find God's will. How can a loving, kind God author something like losing your baby or a miscarriage or anything like that? How is that of God? So she really struggled, and I think we've all been there. If you have ever lived this life, you have struggled with, how is God good and this is so bad? And it's that internal struggle that we all have that says, I want what you have for me, but I don't like where it's going. I don't like the road I'm walking. I don't like the path that I'm on. It's hard. It's dark. I don't see the end. But we have to know that we can only come to His will when we give up and surrender. And some of us are stubborn. And sometimes that surrender is like a battle when it doesn't have to be. But sometimes that surrender is just a brokenness. God, I'm worn out. I have nothing more to give. And when we come to the end of ourselves, we come to the beginning of Him. We come to the beginning of His grace. So if you're fighting anything today, or if you're going to fight something tomorrow, remember that His will is what we want. And it may not seem right, but I'm not God. And I'm going to choose to love Him and worship Him and serve Him in spite of what my eyes see. My eyes lie, but He doesn't. So declare this over your life this morning. Just worship with us as we sing, Thy Will Be Done.
I'm so confused. I know I heard you loud and clear, so I followed through. But somehow I ended up here. I don't want to think, I may never understand. Hurt and these four words, Thy will.
feel that, we need to take time and have family prayer. Pray with families. Our families are under attack. And I know that Jessica, when she walked in this morning, she said, our family needs prayer. Your family needs prayer. I want you to come up here. We're going to have family prayer. Something's been going on. We need to bind together. Because I know the front line of the battle is our family. There'll never be any end to it. But we have provision and we have power to be able to overcome everything that Satan throws against us. I am so convinced that we can come to a place where we experience absolute victory. I don't believe that God sent his son Jesus to suffer and die the way he did for us to just limp through. I believe that in the name of Jesus, we can be victorious. And I'm going to pray to that end, and I'm going to believe, and I want you to believe with me. Father, we are the family of God, and we're all here together. And I know that this is the battle front. This is the front. The tip of the spear is right here in our families. And I'm going to pray right now, Jesus, that we're able to overcome through the power that you'll give us. Not by our will, it's not by our might, it's not a battle of flesh and blood, it's a battle of the Spirit. And Lord, you have to give us wisdom in the Spirit to understand these crazy things that start to happen, that we can be an overcomer, that we can be powerful to tearing down the strongholds that Satan brings against us. God, you've given us that power. You said, I'm going to send the Holy Spirit, and he's going to empower you, and he's going to give you direction, and he's going to lead you, and he's going to guide you, and he's going to be the very thing that controls your mind if we allow it to happen. So Lord, help us to break down every barrier that stands between us and you, because you are the answer to every problem. You are the answer to every situation. We can't change people, you do. So Lord, help us to understand that. Help us to understand, Lord, that you don't want us to just be lame, spiritually lame. That isn't what Jesus died for. He died that we can be powerful overcomers, and that the world would know through us that there is an answer, and that answer is the presence and the power of the Holy Spirit of Almighty God in us, giving us the ability to see things different, to respond different, and to be able to take control through the power of the Holy Spirit of our situations and our circumstances, until we absolutely are so powerful that Satan has to try to hit us from another direction.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So Lord, I pray right now that we'll all start to understand that. And we can't just conjure that up. It has to be a witness through the presence and the power of the Holy Spirit. So, Lord, I'm praying right now that you give everybody that's up here a witness, that witness is your presence and your power. That witness is that, hey, I got this thing. That witness is I can trust him. That witness gives us the ability to see things as they really are. Open our spiritual eyes, Lord, right now. Open our spiritual eyes. Let us see things for what they really are. Not through the smoke and mirrors and deception of Satan and all that he would do to destroy us, but let us see it, Lord, through your glory, through your presence, through the blood of Calvary, in Jesus' name. A big deal. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Jesus.
You release me, redeem me. You call me as your own. You amaze me.
my strength. Defender, you're my refuge in the storm, and through these trials, you've always been faithful.
Stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard tender whispers of love in the dead of night, and you tell that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. 'Cause you're a good, good father. It's who you are, it's who you are, it's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. Searching for answers far and wide, but I know that we're all searching for answers. Only you can provide, 'cause you know just what we need. before we say a word. 'Cause you're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You're perfect in all of your ways. And you're perfect in all of your ways to us. And you're perfect in all of your ways. And you're perfect in all of your ways. And you're perfect in all of your ways to you're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You're a good, good father. It's who you are. It's who you are. Who I am, it's who I am, and you're perfect in all of your ways, and you're perfect in all of your ways, and you're perfect in all of your ways to us. You say, and you're perfect. Who you are, it's who you are. I'm
anybody have anything on their heart they want to testify about? Satan is defeated by our testimony. Is there anybody who wants to testify? I know you do.
Yes, I love Jesus. It seems like since Billy's passed away that I've gotten closer and closer to God. I miss Billy, and I'm thankful that God took him to heaven. And if any of you aren't ready for God, please get saved. Because the way he died, because he just started to pull in our driveway and went out in the ditch and had a massive heart attack and died. And he was healthy. That's what I don't understand. But look, only God knows. So I love him with all my heart.
Amen.
It's interesting. interesting this morning. It's easy to come in and almost like you're taking on a heaviness that you're feeling, woe is me, this type of thing. That's what I felt. And I thought, it was like, that's wrong. Look at what he's done. Look what he's doing. We've got to look at his word and keep that in our hearts and minds so that that overcomes all that heaviness. God's able to do anything.
Never done this before.
We've been praying for many, 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 many years. My son, he's 26. He decided he wanted to go live with his mom years and years ago. I've always been praying that maybe one of these days, maybe he'll come back around. Maybe he'll make an effort. And today, he texted my daughter and wanted to meet up with her in Beaver Creek for lunch. We'll see what happens from there, but I'm thankful, very thankful that it's just a small step. Maybe we'll go, maybe something else. But I praise God for that. I really do, because it's been years and years and years. And there's not a day go by that I don't think about him. Every night I lay my head down, I think about him. And we just never seen eye to eye when we were all trying to grow up. So I just want to tell my daughter that I love her. Be strong. And it's happening for a reason, baby. Amen.
Amen.
This church is very special. And when John come over, and I just love this guy. And I mean, when you say to somebody, boy, you're a blessing, you know, I mean, he is a blessing. I mean, a blessing to all these people. I mean, God has blessed him with the gifts to build his kingdom, to build his church, to build a community, to help hurting people, me, you, every one of us, and do it with such great attributes for not only himself, but to the church and to the community. And I just commend this guy, and I thank him, and I love him. And he is a blessing. And he has blessed this community. And his wife, Glenda. Glenda, where are you? I always know you love to come forward. I mean, they are just such a blessing to so many people. I mean, we're all hurting. I mean, we all got stuff. We all got things. But you can walk in these doors and carry all these weights on you and come in here and let him speak the word of God through him, through to us. And then you walk out of here and you're like, man, I'm new. I'm different. And it isn't him, it's God that's doing it. We understand that. But it takes someone like him that can implement it, that can take those steps forward, that can say those words that touches my heart, that touches your heart, that touches your heart. And he's such a blessing. And you people at this church are such a blessing. A blessing to one another. It starts here, but it doesn't stop here. It continues of having relationships. I mean, I think of the relationships that me and my wife Sunny have with Matt and Nikki Hegler and how other people see those relationships and they talk about it and they say, boy, you guys are different. What's going on? What's happening? And it all starts with God speaking through him that speaks to us, that comes out, changes lives, changes people, changes communities, helps hurting people like my mom that lost a husband, you know. I mean, it's a blessing that dad died the way he died. It's a blessing that he's in heaven. It's a blessing. You can't sit here and grieve. But I also didn't live with him for 50 years, okay? It's a hurting thing, and it is hurting. But but you can still come into this place, release that hurt, release the problems we have. You know, we all got different things. Some people have cancer. Some people have marital problems. Some people have kids that are in trouble. Some people's addicted to drugs. Some people, I mean, it's all that stuff. But it's okay to come in here and release it all. Let it out. Listen to the music. Give it up. And it all starts with a man that was willing to be obedient to change his life, sitting in a bar some night, like all of us have sat in bars and drunk beer and sit there and thought we had the world figured out, to be obedient and say, from this day forward, I'm going to serve the Lord. That's what he's did. And I love you.
Good morning. He just brought up something I've been struggling with, and I want to come up several times and don't listen to God like I should, but I just lost my sister November 20th last year. She's 38 years old, and this church has been a blessing to me, because if you've never losing a child, for my mom, I watch her and I see how hard it is, but when you lose, she's my baby sister. Just doesn't seem like it's supposed to be that way, and she struggled for probably since 2005, and for some of you that know me, she went from a brain tumor to a triple bypass to a stroke to one thing after the other. And I've watched my mom try to take care of her. And when you have that many things go on, it almost gets like dementia. Like sometimes she would sound like she was 80 years old. Sometimes she would walk. She had to walk with a walker because she ended up with sugar in her feet and everything was so messed up. Sometimes she couldn't even feel it. So she didn't know. And I was just getting ready to bring her here, actually, right before she passed away. She's in a lot of pain, and she started sending messages. I come from a background of a family on my dad's side that, my grandma prayed for you. Let me just say that you started praying because you knew something was going to happen. So she started reaching out to my aunts, even though she wasn't totally always in her right mind. And she would say things like how she felt God was talking to her. And she was saved and baptized when she was a kid, but sometimes when it gets that way, you get so busy in life. I have three kids of my own and a job, and she would call, and she was home by herself a lot. And you look back and you think, I should have spent more time, or I should have went. But you can't do that. And I got really angry at God at first. And I remember my grandma telling me when I was younger that it's okay to be mad at God because he already knows you're mad at him anyway. So just get it right out there and tell him that. So for the first few weeks, I struggled. But the first Sunday, I came on to church because I could feel the devil trying to get me not to. And it's easy. Like that song earlier, you know, that's one of the songs I listen to all the time on the way to work, because you can be fine no matter what anybody tells you, and you can be driving to work or be at work and something happened and it comes all back. I don't think it ever gets better. I think you learn how to go through life and deal with it. But, you know, homecoming was just last night, and she has two boys, and she loved my girls, so that was huge to her to come to that. So things like that bring that back up, and my mom's struggling really hard. But what I wanted to say out of all this that made me think of it when he said that is, when I have those moments, I'll tell you, I blast Christian music on the radio, and I just start praying because I know someday I'm going to see her again. And the one comfort I have is she passed away in her sleep. And I know how much pain she has been in, so I firmly believe that she got close enough with God again, and she got comfortable, and she relaxed, and she just let go. And, you know, I was there that night. My mom called me and we went. She was still in the house, and that's an awful scene. You know, my mom beside her, not wanting to let her go. And it was November, and as she went to go out the door, you know, they've got her on the gurney. And I fell to my knees at the door because I thought, I don't want her to go be by herself. You know, that's all you think. It's the first night I can remember ever she's probably been by herself. And I felt God say to me, Angie, she's not by herself. She's with me. What are you crying about? So anyway, I appreciate you guys, because sometimes you may not realize, but there's days I get up and I think I can't make it through the week, but I come in here and that little hug, or pastor saying, as you walk in, he just bends down and says, I love you, just out of the blue. And that's all you need to hear, so thank you.
Yes,
I just believe this morning, I've just felt an overcoming feeling of this, that the Lord is saying, anoint us. We need an extra shield this week. Just anoint us all.
In Jesus' name, hallelujah. Amen. Jesus' name, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Nick asked me if the elders would come up here with me, and wives of the elders, come up here with your husband. And Nick felt led to pray a blessing on us. That's very scriptural. Steve, Glenda,
dear Heavenly Father, we come to you today. Father, I thank you for not only John and Glenda and their leadership in this church, but I pray for these elders and their wives. Lord, there's big things going to happen, and I don't know what they are. But Lord, I just ask that you please bless Rick and Deb. Lord, take the fear away. Give them the wisdom and the knowledge to not only take care of themselves, but to be the leaders of people in the church and in the community. Lord, I just ask that you bless them. Bless them. Lord, I thank you for John. Lord, bless him. I mean, he has been obedient, and I know that deep down inside there's some fear or some anxiety of, boy, this vision that I've had, how's it going to work? How's it going to get paid for? How's it going to happen? And it's going to be all right. Lord, I just ask you to bless him and be with him. Continue to allow him to lead and to help change lives of people in this community. Continue to be able to teach. He's such a blessed teacher, but sometimes he gets the daggone busy. Sometimes he can't focus on teaching. Lord, give him some time. Yes. Give him some blessing. And bless Glenda. Bless her as she's the first lady of this church. She puts up with a lot. She's trying to be a mom. She's trying to be a wife. She's trying to be a spiritual leader. And I guarantee you, wearing all those hats, some days that ain't easy. Plus, she's trying to cook for everybody most days. Lord, just bless her. Continue to bless her. Father, bless Matt. I love this guy. He's helped change my life. You've worked through him. Continue to bless him. Take the fear away from him. Take the anxiety away from him. Continue to let him be a leader. Continue to let him be a leader. He's had a lot going on in his life, but Lord, let him let that stuff out of there. Continue to lead this place. And his wonderful wife, she's been a great leader, been a great wife, helped save Matt's life. It's helped change a lot of people. Working on a great Bible study with my wife, and I know there's a lot of ladies that said they've enjoyed it. I mean, continue to use them. Continue to use them. Lord Steve, Lord, you've blessed him so much. I thank the world of Steve, because you know what? There ain't too many business people in Washington Courthouse that's got the heart for the Lord like Steve's got. And that's a special gift. It's a special gift. And Lord, that's why you've allowed him to be a leader here and an elder here. Lord, I just ask you to continue to give these guys and their wives the wisdom and the knowledge to do what your will is to build the kingdom of God. Continue to give them the wisdom and the knowledge. Lord, I love every one of them here. You're using them for great things. And I thank them so much for for their time and their efforts. And as a church, we love them, we appreciate them, we thank them, and we just want in these days ahead, when we know there's going to be troubles, we know there's going to be problems, we know things ain't going to work out the way we thought they worked out, we know this church ain't probably going to be exactly what it's going to be, and we're going to have to start thinking about building on a wing to this church because it ain't going to be big enough. Lord, just continue to bless them. In Jesus' name. And we all say, amen.
Sacrifice given for all of our trouble. Not just a few things, but all of it. And he said, just trust me. Just trust me. Just allow me to take your broken stuff and put it all back together. So he went up to the right hand of the Father and he told everybody, then I'm going to go a step farther. I'm going to send the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And you might have been baptized with water, but he said, now you're going to be baptized with fire.
Amen.
To burn out all that garbage. To help you through. So Jesus said, I'll sit at the right hand of the Father, and when you've got a problem, you let me know, and I'll tell the Father about it in terms that he understands, because you may not be able to. You may just be groaning and uttering, but I know what you mean. And I'll transpose that into a melody that the Lord will be pleased with. When you don't even know how to pray, he takes your heart and he puts it before the Lord, and God himself reads your heart. Is that amazing? The deepest feelings that we have that maybe no one knows anything about, Jesus lays them before the Father. And since he created everything, he knows how to fix everything. You're here this morning and you've never allowed Christ Jesus to take over your life. It's as simple as just opening up and allowing him in. Sorry for your sins. Ask for his forgiveness and he moves right in and we repent and he starts working with us and we get better. Sometimes we take a few baby steps. But maybe this morning in this atmosphere, the too good to be true news is that Jesus loves you. He died for you. And he wants to take all your stuff before the Father. maybe this morning you just want to accept him as your Savior. We've been up here and we've been releasing all the stuff, because the folks that are standing around here understand, as we go through life and we experience the experience of allowing God to take care of our stuff, and then we'll slide a little bit, we'll get a little bit jaded, and we'll get just a little bit stone cold, and then we get revived, and then all the stuff starts to release again, and then everything gets better. Maybe this morning you just need to know Jesus as your Savior. And we're just all up here as a family, and we want you to join the family of God. So if you'd like to do that, you come up here and let us love on you just a minute while they sing one more time.
Listen.
A good dream.
Yeah.
It was weird. She was in my face and she said, "Are you doing what you need to be doing?" It was so vivid. And I came up and I told her that. And she said to me, "When you fail, you don't have to start at the beginning again. You get to be picked back up and keep going." And she said that to me. And oh my goodness, that is so awesome. And God is so great.
Yes, he is.
Because he knows that I step back, and then I get back on, and then I step back, and I get back on. But he always loves me.
Yes, he does. He does, Becca.
Take them.
Go ahead, if you would, and put prayer requests up. We'll do that and take an offering. Father, we just, Father, we thank you for you coming into our presence today. And Lord, the atmosphere is people's being healed and saved and set free. But we lift up this group of people that's up there, Lord, and I know there's many more. I know there's miracles that's happened up there. There's some that we've lost. But Father, I know that you're in the middle of it and you can take care of it. Lord, I just ask that you continue to intervene. Lord, to give us wisdom when we need it, guidance when we need it, Father. And Lord, as we get farther along in this, Lord, teach us to listen to your voice and heed to your commands. I know there's been times, Lord, in my life where you've told me to pray for someone when I know I should have, I didn't. So, Father, I thank you that you keep plugging away. And we get wiser. So I lift these folks up to you, Father, and I thank you for the miracles that's happening there with some that we're seeing great things. I thank you for intervention in the story a little while ago, Father, that you intervened on someone's behalf and their life's been spared. So, Father, I thank you. Lord, I thank you for the ability to give, Father, and thank you for this offering. I thank you for the right that you've given us to come into a place like this today. And Lord, I thank you we don't have an agenda in this church. We allow you to work, and that's what we're supposed to be doing. So, Father, we give this to you now, and we thank you, Father, for it in Jesus' name. Amen.
They filmed it, and the whole world saw it. The one thing they did not film, because they said it was too sacred and too holy, was the anointing. Because she was anointed in the name of Jesus. She was anointed to be something very special, to be an influence over her whole country, to be a pillar in the times of trouble, to be an exceptional individual that could put herself second and put her people first. But she was anointed not only to be the queen, but to have the very presence and the power of God on her life to be able to carry that out. And that hit me when I saw that. That somehow through the ages, from the early church, clear back to the kings of Israel, the anointing brought a very special, very almost too big of a assignment on a person that you can only carry it out with the presence and power of God. And as I was just anointing people, and Phil, that was a word from God, I know, because I just started to feel that you're being anointed for an assignment that's bigger than you are, with the ability to do things through the power of God that we're not able to do. So Lord, as we go out of this place, help us to carry that anointing into our world, into our environment, into our families, into our workplace, Lord, into our everyday lives, because this thing is for our everyday life. And I'm going to pray right now that we somehow start to learn that through you and through your power, the anointing will carry us through, and that we will be able to do great things. We will be an inspiration. We will be a pillar. We will be a light in a dark place. In the name of Jesus, amen. You are dismissed.